Let's see, Lorraine. What do the spirits have in store for you today? What? I'm seeing something.
Is it a man?
Well, I'll be darned. It is. Oh. Do you know a Bill?
No.
How about a Bob?
No.
Jack?
No.
Mike?
No.
You don't know anybody named Mike?
No.
Girl, you gotta get out of the house more. Lucky for you, I'm running a special on love potions this week.
Oh.
Now, for only $99.95, you can get my special deluxe love kit, guaranteed to give you a lifetime of matrimonial bliss with the man of your dreams.
Who will take it?
Ooh, smart girl. And, wouldn't it be worth an extra $20 for him to be faithful?
Definitely.
Now, what you do, Miss Wiesner, is you drink this little bottle of love potion, then you get naked, and you dance around this little red candle like crazy until you work up a real good sweat.
Ew, not a pretty picture.
Oh, Renfield, don't be so catty.
What?
Oh, I was just talking to the cat.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, you do this every night until Mr. Wright windsurfs into your life.
Oh, Elvira, how can I ever thank you?
Next time, bring cash.
Hello?
Hello? I'm back. Come in.
Careful of the step.
Minerva? What the heck are you doing with that shopping cart?
Oh, don't worry, dear. I'll send it right back to the store.
Minerva, what have I always told you about exposing yourself?
Oh, dear. Did I tuck my skirt into my pantyhose again?
No. I mean exposing your witchcraft.
Oh.
Come on, you know the rules. As long as you don't do it in public, you can do it as much as you like.
Or until you need glasses. Oops, too late.
You shut up, you furball, or I'll have you neutered again. Oh, Elvira, I hate living in the closet.
Look, I don't like it any better than you do, but I'm sick and tired of pulling up stakes just to keep from getting burned at one. Besides, I like living here in Manhattan.
Oh, yes, glamorous Manhattan. When you told me we were moving to Manhattan, I thought Broadway, Times Square. But no, you meant Manhattan, Kansas. The Little Apple, the city that always sleeps.
Look, the main thing is that nobody's caught on to the fact that we're witches, and I'd like to keep it that way. Okay?
Well, it's not as if we were Siegfried and Roy. I mean, we can only do a few harmless parlor tricks, moving shopping carts, fixing parking meters, switching price codes.
You can switch price codes?
Of course. Look, I got this family-sized jar of chunky peanut butter for only 25 cents.
Did you get my shaving cream?
I knew I forgot something.
Oh, great. I'll just spread this on my legs and let the rats chew off the hairs. Now, can you please take this shopping cart back to the store?
Well, can I at least ride in it?
Minerva?
I'll push it.
Oh, Minnie, bring back some kitty litter, or you'll be sorry.
Does everything. Dried fruits, jalapenos, bridge mix, and pressed meats. But this five.
Look at that, Renfield. A five-tray electric food dehydrator. Imagine, we could make hundreds of pounds of beef jerky.
Stop, I'm grueling. Switch it back to Sharon the fat lady.
I'm coming. Hold your horseshoes.
Hey there, pretty lady.
Renfield, did we order a hunky stud muffin from the home shopping club?
Who is that? Oh.
Excuse me, but which one of you is a psychic?
I am. I have to excuse my aunt. She's getting senile. I was going to put her in one of those homes, but you know how they mistreat the elderly.
Okay, you can have him. I had the insurance salesman.
So, you must be Elvira.
No, I must be dreaming. And you are?
Chip. Chip Taylor.
Oh, Chip as in potato? Bet I can't eat just one. Walk this way. Dock your dinghy, sailor. Let's see. Oh, Chip, I see big things in your future.
Really?
Yes. Would you like to see more?
Yes, ma'am. But actually, what I really came here for was friends of mine told me that you sell love potions, and I'd like to buy one. How much is it?
I don't know. How about if I just lip wrestle you for it? Minerva, I've got the door! Hold that thought, Chip. Right between your knees. Oh, put me down for 2 boxes of chocolate mint and 1 vanilla cream. Thanks! You didn't have to pay till you got the cookies.
I can see that you're busy.
Busy? Whatever gave you that idea? See? I'm completely free. At least for the first 3 minutes.
How about if I just come back tonight?
Oh, tonight. Groovy. Yeah, I'll come back tonight and I'll give you my happy hour special. 2 for the price of 1. Are you still here? What do you want?
My name is Paige Grayson.
Yeah, so?
I'm your niece.
On my knees? I ain't getting on my knees for no Girl Scout.
No. I'm your niece. Aunt Elvira! Minerva! Minerva! Oh, I'll have 1 chocolate mint and 2 golden nut clusters.
Minerva, this young lady in the clunky shoes seems to think she's related to us.
You must be Paige. Oh, darling, I'm your great aunt Minerva. Oh, let me look at you. Oh, my, how you've grown.
But you've never seen me before.
Well, I'm assuming you used to be much smaller.
Wait a sec. Who is she?
She's Elvin's child.
But my brother never told me he had any kids.
He didn't know it himself. He died before she was born. Her mother disappeared a few years ago in a mysterious boating accident in the Bermuda Triangle. Poor dear Paige. She was raised by nuns on a remote island off the coast of Maine. Now she's come to stay with us.
Well, that just explains everything.
It wasn't until I turned 18 that the sisters warned, told me about you. This is the first time I've ever been away from boarding school.
Oh, so that's a uniform. Oh, thank God. I thought you just had really bad taste.
The sisters taught us not to dress in a way that could tempt men to sin.
Well, let that be a lesson to you, dear. Never take fashion tips from a nun.
Mother Superior would never approve of that outfit.
Hey, opportunity only gives you knockers once.
Paige, darling, come. Sit down and tell us all about yourself.
Yes, what do you like to do for fun?
Well, I like to clean.
Well, then this place ought to be one big non-stop party for you, girl.
I hope so. I've always dreamed of having a happy, normal family life. Sunday drives, playing Scrabble by the fire, setting up a lemonade stand in the front yard.
Oh, and you can be June Cleaver, and Minerva can be Ward, and I'll be the Beaver. Minerva, she's way too straight to be one of us.
You're right. Sometimes the gift can skip a generation. We'd better find out.
Okay, but remember, be subtle.
Subtle is my middle name. So, Paige, when did you consummate your union with the incubus?
Minerva said she always gets constipated when she rides the bus. Minerva, remind me to make you that appointment with Dr. Kevorkian. So, Paige, you know, my brother was quite, gifted. Surely you must have inherited some of his talents?
Yes, I did. I can speak Latin and play the accordion.
Where? Our Lady of Perpetual Polka?
Listen, Paige, why don't you just run on upstairs and take a nice, long, hot bath?
All right.
Oh, if she floats, she's a witch. If she drowns, our troubles are over.
Officer Taylor is here to see you.
Show him in.
Officer Taylor reporting.
Thank you, Maxine. That will be all.
Uh-huh.
Hey there, pretty lady.
Don't you pretty lady me.
Ooh, chip. As in potato? But I can't eat just one.
Well, I guess I don't have to ask if the wire worked.
Officer Taylor, in case you forgot, your assignment was to nail her.
Believe me, there is nothing I'd rather do.
Chip! You're going back in there alone. That love potion she sold Lorraine Wiesner put her in the hospital. What if she drugs you and takes advantage of you?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah, that would be terrible.
You just remember, Chippy. I'm going to be listening to everything that goes on tonight. And if you're not out of there by 10 o'clock, I'm sending in the SWAT team.
Come on, carpet. Say ah.
Oh, going somewhere, dear?
Very funny. I've got a date with Chip tonight, and I plan on getting rug burns on every square inch of my body.
Okay. I finished cleaning the oven. But I'm still waiting for the freezer to defrost.
Oh, you can finish that later, Cinderella. Right now, you and Aunt Minerva are going out to have some fun. So just run on upstairs and change clothes.
I did.
Oh, yeah, the rubber gloves are a nice touch. Let's see. There must be lots of fun things for you guys to do in this town. Look! The future farmers of the Flatlands are having a cakewalk and corn shucking contest.
That sounds like fun.
Well, actually, I'm rather tired. Why don't you go shuck yourself, dear?
Minerva!
Okay, okay. Come, child. We are going to paint the town gray.
And Minerva! Ixnay on the adjigme in front of age pay.
Yeah, app cray.
Oh.
entree.
Hi.
Oh, Chip, I wasn't expecting you so soon. And look at me. I'm a mess.
I think you look pretty cute.
Oh, bet you say that to all the ghouls. Sit down and make yourself comfortable. Oops. Can I get you a beverage?
Oh, you mean a drink? Oh, sure. Well, how about that love potion?
Oh, Chip. Why would a handsome stud like you need a love potion?
Well, sometimes I have, a problem.
Oh, problem. Oh, that kind of problem. Oh, well, I think we could fix that with a little physical therapy.
That would be great, but how about the love potion first?
Well, okay. I'll get the potion. Then you get the notion. Ow! I wonder if this is going to be strong enough. I don't know how big his problem is. I know. I'll just add a little extra starch. Here we are. A nice, big drink.
Thanks, Elvira. What do I owe you?
Oh, it's on me. And after you drink it, you will be too.
I'm afraid I'm gonna have to take it to go. You see, I have a date.
A date? Chip, no. Let me see your hand. Oh, no, Chip. She's all wrong for you. I mean, she's all sweaty and wrinkled and calloused. Take my advice. Drop her. Drop her like a hot potato, Chip.
You're making it awful hard on me, but I really gotta go. Have the potion back, please?
No. Why should I, you two-timer?
Hey, give me that.
No!
Give me that!
No!
Give me that!
No! Chip! Chip, are you okay? Chip! Gosh, he's hard as a rock!
Well, wasn't that the whole point?
Wait a minute. What's this?
Timber!
Oh, my Godzilla. He's a policeman. What am I going to do with a big, stiff cop?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, my God. They're back. I can't let Paige see you like this. Curly.
I ran out of cakes. Aunt Minerva won them all. It was incredible.
Just beginner's luck.
There's more in the car.
Oh, Minerva, look at this. It's Chip. My love potion turned him stiff as a board.
Well, wasn't that the whole point?
He's an undercover cop.
Oh, my goodness. You could get the chair for turning him into a table.
Minerva, you gotta do something to loosen him up.
Well, how about a martini and a massage?
Well, maybe later, but right now I think we ought to do something about Chip.
Wait a minute, let me see. Reverse the spell from this lovely madam. I command thee now, up and at 'em.
It's working! It's working!
Uh-oh, I think I put too much up in his atom.
Boy, I know the refrigerator's finished defrosting, so I have some place to put these.
What are you doing?
Oh, just a little redecorating.
Really? Here, Aunt Minerva.
Devil's food, my favorite.
How do you explain this?
Oh, well, Paige, you know how I like to pick up men.
I didn't want to believe it, but it's true. Both of you, you're witches.
Witches?
Us?
It's no use. She's on to us. Okay, what are you gonna do? Turn us in?
No. I just don't want any part of this. I'm leaving.
Well, break out the champagne and little frisky.
That's enough out of you, you nasty old cat.
Paige, you heard Renfield talk?
Yes, so?
Only a witch can hear animals' thoughts.
Paige, you're one of us.
No, I'm not like you. I want to be normal, like everybody else. I hate being different.
But what's wrong with being different? Look where it's gotten me. No, what I meant to say is, you're the only you have, and if you're not going to be you, well, who is going to be you? Who? I don't know. I was just trying to make you feel better. But I wouldn't be trying if I didn't really care.
And we do, dear. Very, very much.
I'm out of here. Ciao.
If Officer Chip Taylor does not come out in 1 minute, we're coming in after him.
Come and get me, you dirty coppers!
Minerva, what is the matter with you?
Nothing. I just always wanted to say that.
You see what I mean? Using witchcraft causes nothing but trouble. Minerva, take Paige and sneak out the secret tunnel. I'm turning myself in.
Into what?
Just remember, Paige, I'm not just doing this for you, but for our kind everywhere. And all the other freaks and misfits who dare to be different. Because if I have to live in a world where everybody is forced to be the same, well, they may as well just lock me away. Because I'll already be living in prison.
You have to reverse the spell. Do it. Chip!
Oh.
This is a bust.
No, this is a bust.
You're under arrest.
For what?
For selling Lorraine Wiesner a potion that put her in the hospital.
But that was just some plain old herb tea. Okay, well, a couple of toenail clippings.
Tell it to the judge.
Oh, Elvira, what are you doing?
Oh, probably 8 to 10, thanks to you, Lorraine.
Miss Wiesner, I'm glad you're here. Now you can officially press charges against this woman for poisoning you.
But I wasn't poisoned. I got pneumonia from dancing around a candle naked.
But I can still arrest her for selling phony love potions.
The love potion worked. If I hadn't been hospitalized, I never would have met my fiancé, Dr. Marvin Zislis.
We just dropped by to say thank you for making Lorraine sick.
It was my pleasure. But why don't you come back later when I'm not tied up? Now, get me out of here or I'll sue you for penetrating my civil rights.
Well, let her go.
Chip, how could you have kissed that trash?
Hey, honey, at least trash gets picked up sometime.
Look, Elvira, I'm real sorry about all this. No hard feelings?
I don't know. Maybe later.
Would you like another piece of cake, dear?
Ugh, no. If I have any more cake, I'm gonna blow up like a poison dog in the sun.
Hey, Paige, this tea is delicious. What's in it?
Oh, just some things I found in the pantry.
Which things?
Yes, they were.
No, I mean, what's in it?
Oh, it's just herb tea. Oh. And some toenail clippings.
Whoa.
No, it was a joke, I think.
Almost, dear. But you're learning.
Yeah, before you know it, we'll have you flying around here in a pointy hat and a pointy bra.